This is a pool table. When the ball is hit, it moves to a certain distance and slowly comes to halt. How and why does this happen? Let's start the lesson and find answers to such questions. Objectives. At the end of this lesson, you will be able to define friction, illustrate smooth and rough surfaces, describe the types of friction, discuss advantages and disadvantages of friction, illustrate the way to reduce or increase the friction. Yes?
What we see, हमने क्या देखा? What is friction? What is friction? Friction is like to oppose something. When something is moving, some object is moving, whatever thing is moving, there is some friction that opposes that movement. It's called friction. Okay? Now, in this chapter, what we are going to read, that is define friction, illustrate smooth and rough surfaces, how many types of surfaces we are having, smooth and rough, both surfaces we are having. Now, next is this, describe the types of frictions, how many types of frictions we are having, that we will discuss in this chapter. No need to panic about these things. You order the these things, okay? Now, discuss advantages and disadvantages of frictions. What are the advantages and what are the disadvantages of the friction? Now, illustrate the way to reduce or increase the friction. Sometimes we want friction, but sometimes we don't want frictions. These are the conditions. कहाँ पे हमें friction की ज़रूरत होती है, कहाँ पे नहीं होती है, वो conditions भी होगी. तो हम किस तरीके से friction को बढ़ा सकते हैं, किस तरीके से friction को कम कर सकते हैं, वो भी हम इस chapter में read करेंगे. Okay? Now, see you.
Let's take an example from daily life. While moving on a bicycle on the road, you pedal the bicycle and it moves on and on. When you stop pedaling, the bicycle slows down and gradually comes to a stop. Why does this happen? This actually happens because of friction. Friction is a force that is created whenever two surfaces move or try to move across each other.
What is friction? Friction is a force that is created when two surfaces move or try to cross each other. Like when two surfaces are in contact or they are moving, or one is at constant place and another is crossing the first surface, then it is called friction. The friction is going to be generated between two objects only, two bodies only. Jab do bodies only, tabhi friction generate hota hai. Okay, got it right now?
Yes.
Friction always opposes the motion or attempted motion of one surface across another surface. The force which resists the motion of the body while moving on surface is called friction.
Friction always opposes the motion or attempted motion of one surface across another surface. Jab aap bicycle ride karte, when you are riding a bicycle, have you ever seen the road is constant but the bicycle is running on that road? That road is playing the role of the friction to apply the friction to the wheels of the bicycle. Have you ever seen there is the holes and that drawings in the bicycle tires?
Yes.
What are these called? These are for the friction. These tires are made up of like this because for the friction. So that ki jab agar aapka kabhi agar smooth tire ho gaya, to jab aapne agar ek speed pakad li, force apply karke, to kya hoga? वो अगर वहाँ पे फ्रिक्शन लेस हो गए टायर अगर फ्रिक्शन लेस हो गए, उसमें क्या चाहिए? दोनों बॉडीज के बीच में फ्रिक्शन के लिए क्या चाहिए? दोनों बॉडीज में अप एंड डाउन होने चाहिए. अगर अप एंड डाउन नहीं है दोनों बॉडीज में, सपोज रोड एंड टायर दोनों में अप एंड डाउन नहीं है, तो वो रुक पाएंगे नहीं. स्मूथ सर्फेस पे कभी भी फ्रिक्शन अप्लाई नहीं होता, बट हमें रफ सर्फेस मिलेगी तभी हम क्या कर सकते हैं, फ्रिक्शन को अप्लाई कर सकते हैं. राइट?
Friction is dependent on the texture of both surfaces. Friction is also dependent on the amount of contact force pushing the two surfaces together.
कितना force वो apply कर रहा है, push कर रहा है road की तरफ ताकि उसका motion increase हो, इसके ऊपर भी depend करता है. आप जितनी speed से bicycle ride करोगे उतनी ही क्या होगी, friction कम होती जाएगी और उतनी ही smoothly क्या करेगी वो move करेगी. और जितना आप फोर्स कम अप्लाई करोगे वैसे वो क्या होगी, जल्दी स्टॉप हो जाएगी, क्योंकि जाएगी, ठीक है ना?
The simple answer to this is that while in motion, the tires of the bicycle are rubbing against the surface of the road. When two surfaces rub on one another, the force comes into play.
When two surfaces are rubbing, the force of friction is applied. When two surfaces, two rough surfaces, I am not talking about plain surface, I am talking about rough surface. When two rough surfaces are in contact with each other, are rubbing each other, then friction is applied over there. Friction, force of friction is applied in that case. Okay?
This force acts in the direction opposite to the direction of motion. Thus, it slows down the motion and finally brings the moving object to a stop. In figure, a ball is rolled on smooth surface and another similar ball on rough surface. As you see, here that both the...
Now, in both the cases, where the friction is large, more, and where the friction is less. In this case, friction is more or less?
More.
Why? The surface is rough. And in this case, the surface is smooth. That's why the friction is
less.
Very good.
Ball starts rolling on different surfaces with same speed, same force, and at same time. But the ball
which ball reaches first?
The surface.
Why? Because the friction is less. And in this case, the ball reaches late because the friction
is more.
Rolling on smooth surface travels a larger distance than the ball rolling on rough surface. This shows that the rough surfaces offer more friction than smooth surfaces for the same pair of contact surfaces.
Pair is contact surface, pair is same. Here is the earth and a ball. Here is also an earth surface and a ball. But the surface is smooth and rough. Only the difference is there is the surface. About the smooth and rough surface. Rough surface and smooth surface. But the object is same. यहाँ पे भी हमारे पास बॉल है, वहाँ पे भी बॉल है, बट कंडीशन कहाँ चेंज हो रही है कि जो उनकी सरफेस है वो क्या है, डिफरेंट है, इसीलिए इसमें डिफरेंट डिस्टेंस कवर किया है, राइट?
This example proves that friction depends on the texture of contact surfaces.
With the help of this example, we come to know कि फ्रिक्शन किस पे डिपेंड करता है, कॉन्टैक्ट फोर्सेस पे डिपेंड करता है, कॉन्टैक्ट सर्फेसिस पे डिपेंड करता है, किस टाइप की सर्फेस कॉन्टैक्ट में है तो उस पे हमारा फ्रिक्शन डिपेंड करेगा, ठीक है ना?
It is interesting to learn that friction depends on the amount of contact force pushing the two surfaces together. Huh, let us find out. Here a man is trying to push a heavy box. The box is not moving. Have you any idea why this happens? Well, when the box is pushed, the bottom of the box and the floor rub one another and friction comes into play which resists the motion. The force from friction is more than the push force being exerted by the man.
In this case, what happened? A man is trying to push a big box and that box having a large surface area. And when man is forcing that box, why it is not happening? वहाँ पे कुछ movement हो रही, क्यों नहीं हो रहा है ऐसा? Why it is not going to happen?
Because दोनों तरफ rough surfaces हैं.
Both are rough surfaces and the friction applied by the rough surfaces, the friction force is more than the applied force. The friction force that is happening between the two surfaces is more than the applied force. The applied force is applied by the man. जो man ने force apply की है, वो और जो friction जो force apply कर रही है, उसमें किसकी ज़्यादा force है? Friction की ज़्यादा force है. इसीलिए क्यों नहीं move हो रहा है? Because of the frictional force. Okay?
The box will move only when a greater force than the force from friction is applied on the box.
बॉक्स तभी मूव करेगा जब फ्रिक्शनल फोर्स से ज्यादा हम फोर्स अप्लाई करेंगे. जितना सपोज ये पोडियम मुझे मूव करना है तो हाउ कैन आई मूव दैट पोडियम? अगर मैं इस ये जितना है उससे ज्यादा मैं इसको फोर्स अप्लाई करूंगी क्योंकि ये भी बैक फोर्स दे रहा है मुझे, फ्रिक्शन की बैक फोर्स दे रहा है. बट अगर उससे ज्यादा मेरी फोर्स होगी तो इजिली वो मूव कर जाएगा.
you may find it easy to move the box already in motion. This example proves that friction depends on the amount of contact force pushing the two surfaces together. Now we can easily define force of friction. The force of friction is a force which opposes the motion of a body in contact with the surface of another body. It acts on both the surfaces.
What is friction? The force of friction is a force which opposes the motion of a body. कोई भी बॉडी जब मूव कर रही है उसके मूवमेंट को वो अपोज कर रहा है तो उसको क्या बोलते हैं फ्रिक्शन फोर्स बोलते हैं मोशन ऑफ ए बॉडी इन कॉन्टेक्ट विद द सरफेस ऑफ अनदर बॉडी वन सरफेस ये एक सरफेस है बॉडी की ये दूसरी सरफेस है बॉडी की जब ये कॉन्टेक्ट में रहेंगे जब ये मूव करेंगे तो वहाँ पे जो फोर्स एक्ट हो रही है उसको क्या बोलते हैं फ्रिक्शनल फोर्स एंड इट एक्ट्स ऑन बोथ द सरफेस इस पे भी एक्ट करेगी और इस पे भी एक्ट करेगी ओके
Some surfaces are smooth and some are rough. Some are less rough and some are more rough. Even a smooth surface has some irregularities, roughness on it. For example, when we try to move one sandpaper over the other, the movement is not smooth. That means there is friction due to the interlocking of
it. Have you ever seen the sandpaper?
Yes.
That sandpaper having the rough surface. When we are going to rub that sandpaper on plain surface, ever noticed that crumbling sound is also there. You can feel the friction on that paper. Sandpaper tap easily friction ko feel kar sakte, right?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Rough surfaces. But when we try to move one plain paper over the other, movement is.
जब हम एक प्लेन पेपर और दूसरे प्लेन पेपर को मूव करते हैं तो इजीली मूव हो जाते हैं वहीं आपके पास रफ पेपर दैट इज सैंड पेपर होगा तो वो इजीली मूव होगा
नहीं
ठीक है as compared to sand paper thus the roughness of sand paper is more than that of the plain paper so we can say that friction is produced due to the roughness of surfaces depending on the roughness of surfaces The value of frictional force can be more or less.
We can find out the value of the frictional force with the help of the roughness of the surface. Surface की कितनी roughness है उसकी उसको हम कैसे find उसकी help से हम क्या find out कर सकते हैं
frictional
force
find
out कर सकते हैं ठीक है?
So, let us summarize what we have learned. Friction is the force. Which resists the motion of the body while moving on a surface. Force of friction is a force which opposes the motion of the body in contact with the surface of another body. Force of friction depends on the texture of surface and the amount of contact force.
Now, in this video, what we have learned that friction is the force which resists the motion of a body while moving on a surface. And force of friction is the force which opposes the motion of a body in the contact with the surface of another body. Force of friction depends on the texture of surface and amount of contact forces. This video is completed and up to this topic we have completed. Now, for today, we are going to complete this session. Okay?